Yes, a young kid. I'm good, how are you? You looking skinny, Brandon. It's loose. It used to be tight fit jumpsuit.
Oh, Elie, I got you your media credential.
Thank you. Right, it's freezing outside.
Oh, it's so cold, bro.
It's freezing. Oh, I'm wearing shorts. It wasn't that cold over there. Over there.
Hey, you grew up in this place.
It wasn't that cold. It was like 57, 60.
Are you serious?
Brandon, you grew up in this area, right?
Not in Wichita. But I grew up 3 hours from her.
If you got lost and you didn't have GPS, you're screwed because all the roads look the same.
Everything is fucking big, dog. I don't know why you're around here.
What do we eat right now?
Hey, what's up?
You guys what?
What do we eat right now?
Yo, quick.
Have you ate that, bro? Hey, let me see that.
How's it going?
All right. Ready.
Chilling. What's up? What's up? How's everything, though? You good? You're home?
Yeah, we get to go find this.
Kansas.
Not home, but we're fucking here. I'm 3 hours from here.
Yeah, 3 hours, that's fine.
3 hours, yeah.
I thought you were grew up down the street.
Nah, fuck no. We're in Wichita, bro. We're different.
Okay, let me see this, Brandon. Mikey against Spence.
That's gonna be a good ass fight.
Why?
But come on. I go with my boy Mikey. But it's gonna be a technical fight because Mikey's very technical and he's very he doesn't throw a punch to waste a punch. Errol Spence is very technical too and he's very strong. As well as Mikey's very strong. They both can pop. So that fight's a toss up in the air. Whoever lands the first punch and whoever can take it the harder punch. I'm going for Mikey. That's my boy. I think Mikey's going to take him out.
Josecito's fighting Keith Thurman.
Yeah. Let's see how that works. Let's see how that one works out because Keith Thurman's been out of the ring for so long. And he's finding a guy that's fucking durable. He's finding a guy that comes in for Riverside Rocky that comes to fight. So it's going to be an interesting fight, but I'll go for my boy, too.
Okay.
Maybe
cold right now. You see how you disperse a crowd? You turn up a camera and everybody disappears. I'm talking to myself now.
Oh, you better talk to yourself and walk.
That's what's happening.
At least you're back.
Reporting.
You haven't seen Sherry Leonard anywhere?
No, not yet. No, I haven't. But he's here. Canelo, yes, but not here. I don't think he came for his brother's fight.
Well, I thought somebody said he was going to be here.
Really?
Yeah, you better not be recording us.
No, I'm walking after Robert, but...
Better be.
No, usually, I don't know if he'll be here. If I see him, I'll let you guys know.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, where is he? Oh, okay.
He was asking about that.
Robert, hold on. We're going to... let me see where you guys are sitting. Someone started a rumor that Canelo's here. I didn't think so, but
how's it going? He's training. He's training.
Yeah, he's fighting.
Pretty good. How you doing?
Pretty good.
You working over here?
Oh yeah.
They hired you over here?
That's good. He doesn't.
Well, yeah. Freelance.
Huh?
Freelance.
How's it going? No, a lot of HBO people work with DAZN now. I've seen them.
I'm going. Yeah, I get back home. I'm going to work on the Wilder Fury.
Oh, okay. So you're.
I'm freelance.
You're right. That's good.
So you're a hustler.
When you're good at something, they'll hire you, right?
I learned from you. Hey, how's it going, man? I'm getting to see you.
Where's the commission?
I don't know. I just kind of got here.
I get my direct. I got all three.
This is my first trip into the zone.
Oh, okay.
You're in the zone.
I'm in the zone.
What's this?
Ryan, you guys give away.
I think I watched a good video you two made the other day about the Maidana gloves.
Robert, he liked the Maidana gloves video. Where Maidana got paid.
I popped up in my YouTube feed the other day.
And you clicked on it?
Yeah, it was great.
Where Robert says Maidana got paid $1.5
million? They hate me for saying it, but it's true.
Yeah, because they don't want it.
Yeah, you were upset that Leonard was...
Hello.
Are you guys here for the ballet?
Yeah.
Yep.
Ballet.
All right. Perfect. This is
that, you know, best couple, best dad.
20-year high school reunion. You went to
20.
And then they voted most successful.
They know, but see, they have
are filling out the forms for the fight.
Forms, yeah. The forms were, you know, best couple.
Oh, you have to vote. Got it.
Yeah, everybody voted. So.
Who got best couple?
So I don't even remember because it was a big class, but I remember that they had most successful, and. Almost everybody, you know, okay, we've been on TV and all that. So most of them with Robert Garcia.
Yeah.
So at the end, you know, the ones that organized that, we have a draw.
It's high school. Because everybody in Oxford loves Pacquiao.
Yeah. Yeah, there was a lot of Filipinos back then. So it was a draw. So there was.
So who, who did you draw with? What's his name?
It was a, I don't even remember his name.
But he's so successful.
Yeah. Some Filipino guy.
Some name, Manny Pacquiao. He's fighting Adrian Broner.
Best couple, best this, you know.
You miss high school?
Huh?
You miss high school?
Not that I miss it, but it was fun. And then they also had like the couple that's still together from high school and all that. Well,
what a punishment that is.
We didn't go to the.
Can you imagine?
And we didn't go to the same high school, but like we were both in high school when me and my wife.
Yeah, but if we went to the same high school and everybody, you know, like those couples in high school, ninth grade, tenth grade,
and you know, I don't even remember if there was any. I think there was, you know, that they're still together 20 years later.
I'm thinking of my high school. Whenever someone was in a couple, they always went by themselves. They never were.
It was fun. So this summer, it was already 25 years. 25 years since I graduated.
It's crazy.
25 years.
Bro, if you would have gone to school and studied something at university, what would it be?
Nah. I was.
You would have studied law, become a lawyer?
Probably a police officer, because that's... You know,
but I can't see you giving people tickets.
Well, that's why, because I did go through the, I went to the...
The testing?
Yeah, I did stuff like that, but then when I went on a ride-along, I'm like, nah, that's not what I want to do. You know, it's crazy, because
a homie.
I was in a ride-along, okay?
Yeah.
And Oxnard, there's not much, you know, and there wasn't a lot of action going on, so he's like, you want me to stop pulling people, you know, start giving tickets? I'm like, all right. Okay, so for any little reason, he would stop it, you know, and a lot of Mexicans, you know, that probably don't even have insurance
or license or money.
Started giving tickets. Yeah. I'm like, fuck that. I ain't gonna be doing shit like this. To, you know, in Oxnard, it's mostly a lot of people that don't even have insurance or driver's license, I think. So these guys started pulling people over, giving tickets out to Mexicans that, you know.
Who were the cops? Were they Mexicans?
Yeah, I think the one I went with, yeah.
And you still did it to people?
Yeah,
that's fucked up.
And that's what I felt like. Nah, I ain't gonna do shit.
It's not for you.
Yeah, I ain't gonna do this shit.
You might have been good giving tickets, you know?
Yeah.
You think you would have done good if you became an actor? Because you like movies?
Probably not.
Pita, would you that be good if you did like Training Day, the Mexican version?
Nah.
No?
Michael Peña.
Police Academy?
Leave that for the homie, Michael Peña.
He's talented, he likes you.
He's good. Oh yeah, he's a good dude.
If HBO showed the movie Chips one more time, I'm canceling my subscription. They just showed Chips all year.
Yeah.
Have you seen the movie Chips?
Chips, what is it?
A movie.
It used to be the old show, remember?
Oh, Chips, Estrada
was like, what was it? Johnny,
well, Michael Estrada?
Johnny Estrada?
Yeah.
Estrada guy, they made a movie out of it.
No.
I'm
Estrada or something.
I'm Estrada. Right. Yeah.
They made a movie out of it. And Michael Peña plays in that movie.
Who was it when we did the fight with in LA with Triple G beat him?
Rubio.
There was a couple of guys in the dressing room that played in that.
They did.
Mexican mafia.
It was Rubio's manager at that time. They were his friends.
Yeah, it was a pretty decent movie.
I remember
watching that. It was a good gang.
I remember that. Yeah.
Movie. Like, I remember the name.
Eric Estrada.
Eric
Estrada.
That's it.
Yeah. Everybody doing okay?
Yeah, we're doing.
Yes. Thank you. I used to always see him in a coffee shop in Studio City every day, trying to hit on chicks.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. But he hasn't never done anything else, right? He just did that one show, Chips.
That's hopefully that was good enough, and that obviously was to make it, huh?
Pita, give me three professions your dad could do if there was no boxing.
Nothing. Boxing. That's it.
No, like.
Nah, boxing.
I was born for that, bro.
That doesn't make sense. So
can he be a consultant, a life coach?
No. Guarantee you come up with something. Hey, look at him. We expect fighters that retire to do something.
Yeah,
hey, look.
So if he was going to retire from training.
Well, it was because of boxing, too. When I brought in a few kids to the gym from Channelings High School. That once they came to the gym, they started doing really good. They graduated and stuff like that, so that helped.
Yeah,
right? That is good.
I brought in a few.
So you could be a mentor.
Ojo was one of them. And then when he stopped coming to the gym, what happened? He's out of them. Mojo, but he was doing time in prison and shit like that. Others got killed, you know. But when they were in the gym, they were doing good.
Would you in politics if you became a mayor, a senator, a congressman?
Nah.
Why not?
Well, maybe I'll probably do the right thing and help people that need to be helped. Not people that beat the system.
He'd get in trouble telling it like it is.
They don't want to hear that.
They don't want to hear it.
Not hear
really.
It.
I mean, you want to loop it. You don't want to straight line anything about it.
You going to hit the cake?
Yeah, I got the cake.
I'm good. I'm ready for fight night already. Doctors, keep an eye on the temperature. If it starts snowing, we're leaving.
We're out of here.
It doesn't even matter.
No matter what round we're in, if it's snowing, we're
you're leaving the corner. You're just going to get up.
Brandon, knock his ass out now because we got to go.
Well, it's cold enough for snow.
The fight ends, we're leaving, right? When it's snowing.
We're not going to stand around, hug each other for more than walk back, hug each other, and get out of here. Yes.
If it's not snowing, then it's okay.
Well, we're leaving. 10 minutes.
No, we're leaving.
I think best thing to do is
you don't get stuck in here.
If we get back in time, even if we're back, but we can be back by midnight, but we're both right. If he goes in,
he's starting at 8. We could be out of here by 9, 10.
We're good midnight by midnight. We're back here by midnight. We
sleep a couple hours. Yep.
And go.
We go party a little bit early.
That's
Saturday
it.
Saturday night in Oklahoma City.
Where?
Well, I think
in the hotel lobby. Now that everyone left, the place will be deserted.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, they'll close it if you left it.